Right now there is a committee. Yeah. There is a committee called GoI PMS committee.
Okay.
That committee is constantly in touch with the state ministry.
Yeah.
They are having discussion with them and trying to work with them. Keep there are few discrepancies.
Yeah.
Few courses are not listed with the ministries.
Yeah.
There are few issues like some state do not disperse the money because the student is studying in a different state.
Yeah.
So there are discrepancies and ministry is not clear with the status whether we are deemed university or we are central university.
Duty of the institute to ensure that there is financial aid.
Yeah.
Only then they'll be able to come.
What?
Agar financial assistance nahi hoga to bachche paise bhi nahi aa paaye.
Yeah. What I am saying? If my intention is to get more of SC, ST, ODC and girl students here, I must have sufficient money. If I do not have money, where will I go? I get the money from the government. The government does not release money for many political reasons, whatever reason. One may think, we don't know that. But that point you are saying, that the institute did not tell me that I have to pay the fee in the beginning. And now they are saying, is that true?
Yes.
There is a clause in the UGC which is there is a clause in the UGC which says that anything related to the fee structure has to be published on the website and the prospectus or the brochure before the admission. After the admission of the student is being done, you cannot change the fee structure.
But the fee structure has been changed after
yes.
Students students may be asked to pay, but the fees was the fees changed?
Yes, sir.
Yes. If this is 100% funded institute where the course are not professional, how could they charge so much fees? That is also one problem.
He said that we are doing favor to you for the 14 years. We are demanding our rights, sir. We are not taking favors from him. And he gave gali porki tayoli. That's what he called the students. That's what ex-director for 40 or 15 years he teaches here. And he called the students porki tayoli. I don't want to. And that's what our director said to the students who protested. And he said he is doing favor for us.
We are asking for our rights, sir. There have been cases where SEC students have not paid, whatever reason. There were cases where the parent transfer, they left the institute and they went. There were cases where students try applying to the state government for a scholarship. Unfortunately, state government does not respond. The accumulation of this money is quite a huge money. There is some truth in what they have said. Nobody can deny this. It is not that every student who applies scholarship, he gets a scholarship. Some government do not respond. That they have their own reason. You should study in state government college. Why did you go there? All kinds of reasons. There are a lot of legal discrepancies because which some students don't get scholarships despite applying for it. There are some reasons students, some cases students don't apply at all. All these cases, there is considerable amount of money which is gone in the deficit. There is some truth in what they are saying.
We already told them.
Fees, all those kinds of another major. They are not major issues, the SCST financial issues. Two major issues are. My only at this, I take from what you are saying, that they advertise saying that you only have to pay 4,500. After advertisement, after admission, they are asking more. This is the point you are saying. If there is definitely there is some truth, definitely I myself am with you and I will also find out what is happening.
And we are expecting all of your support for us.
But you can't take that, you know, institute cannot be run. Such a huge, you know, backup. You need to pay the fee. That's a larger issue you have to fight. We all have to fight. We all have to fight.
Now, never ever think that this as a university is doing a favor to its students by giving a fee exemption. Never ever think this. This is not a favor. Now, why there has to be an exemption in TISS? It is because there is no other public funded university in this country that has 10,000 or more than 10,000 tuition fee. There is no other university in this country. So, you know, before the fee exemption was given to the SCST students, the number of the SCST students who could come to TISS was not even more than 10. So this was this as a university that talked about the social justice was ashamed to say this, and they had to provide fee shift, which means a constitutional provision for this community to enter this campus. So never ever think that this was a, you know, donation or this was 2 years, even after we withdrawn this policy, which is utter rubbish. We have the data, we have the documents to show that what has been the dropout rate in each classes in the certain communities. We have that, and that clearly says the trend, that clearly shows the picture. So, you know, you think about it. And, you know, there are a lot of arguments given about slavery, you know.
This is a favor, or...
But TISS has done a lot for this historic community. Of course, we respect that, you know, TISS would be, I don't know, maybe first institute to have an Ambedkar Memorial Lecture. Of course, we academically accept that, and we take that in that spirit. But now, TISS will also be one of the universities where we see the highest number of the dropouts from this community. Now, we have to ask this question back. If this is the justice, or if this is the favor, or if this is the great thing that, you know, a university like this is doing, there is something seriously wrong in the core of that. We have to question that. Okay? Not protest, and we are kind of trying to stop these communities entering into the campus, which I personally don't believe. I don't know how many of you take that argument, because, you know, if we don't protest now, we are actually, you know, favoring the entry of these students into these very spaces. So if we don't do that, students are not going to come. Of course, we accept that there is a historical affirmation policy, historical steps which have been taken by not only Professor Ramayya, Professor, I would like to take the name of Professor Vankade, who has been very instrumental in setting up a lot of mechanisms here. So we of course remember them, we take that with extreme respect. At the same time, we take this issue very seriously that we have in front of us. If we don't question that, then maybe the coming generations will ask us, or will blame us, that why did not you ask this when this was happening in front of you, in front of you. The GoI scholarship, there are issues, there are irregularities where, you know, some states do not have a provision for a GoI fellowship. Now, what all students face is that even if the state don't, issue a notification, or students go to the local social welfare officers or the taluka officers, go there, sit there, give application there, and they mostly don't get their scholarships. This is a problem now. Now, you know, I think we should again come back to the point that I said that the university like this, there is no other so-called, it still writes that, you know, we are a 100% public funded university. If that is the case of the university, then, we should not have this much fee where states, you know, the state governments don't give so much money to pay the tuition fees. A state government like maybe Jharkhand or Bihar, they will not be able to pay 10,000 for only one student's, tuition fee. This is only tuition fee. These are the states that also have a lot of other priorities in their hand. These are the states that have, you know, one of the highest illiteracy, one of the highest malnutrition. Why should they want to spend money for a student who is coming for a postgraduate education and to fund only his or her tuition fee for 10,000? So, you know, these are practical problems also for us to think, and how we should put forward our demands. This is what I think I largely have to say. And any of the protests, any of the kind of arguments that we put forward, we haven't done any violence here. We haven't, humne kisi tod-phod nahi kiya hai. We haven't. And I clearly remember, I was part of, you know, I still remember last year or last year, the contract workers of the DH was not paid their wages. I think still they are having problems, and student community have stood with them. So, you know, and even security staff, there are more than half of the security staff who have been appointed on contractual basis, okay? Many of them have been facing issues. So, inside there is a kind of conspiracy which is going on to make a fight between the students, staff, faculty, So, we should not get into the trap of that. And we should also be clear always that we have always been stood with all these communities and we will continue to stand with them and they will also continue to stand with us actually. We should also talk to them, engage with them and understand them that we are not your enemies. We are not your enemies and you are not our enemies also. Okay, now.